Greetings, everyone. Let me turn the camera around. Okay, here we go. Get everything together here. Thank you for joining me, Dr. Jarrett, today on Mindset Monday. I am Dr. Michelle Clay. I am speaker, author, holistic physician who specializes in stress. I help exhausted executives, stressed out and burnt out professionals release their stress simply and naturally so that you can find your happy, healthy place and live a free life on passion and with purpose. So I hope everyone had a great weekend. I know there were some ups and downs, there were some lows, and there were some highs for some people. And today is Monday, and thank you for joining me for Mindset Monday. So today's topic is how to overcome disappointment and start anew. How do you create a fresh start after encountering disappointment? Well, and I'm going to give you 5 tips for that, okay? First of all, let's define disappointment. What, according to Oxford's dictionary, the definition of disappointment is a feeling of sadness, displeasure caused by non-fulfillment of one's hopes or expectations. We're going to get back to that in just a little bit. What is the opposite of disappointment? The opposite of disappointment is success, achievement, happiness, and pleasure. So how do you overcome, move forward, and create a fresh start after encountering disappointment? Tip number one, you have to make sure that you focus on the positive. Do not focus on the negative. A lot of times when things occur or things don't occur the way that we want them to or the way that we envision. Thank you for joining me, Your Greater Way. Thank you so much for joining me. Invite your followers, invite your friends, for people that need information on how to overcome disappointment and create a fresh start. Thank you, Dr. Jarrett, for putting that number one, focus on the positive. Do not focus on the negatives. A lot of times what happens when we're disappointed, things don't happen the way that we want them to, then we settle in that. We just brood in it. It's like a cesspool. And sometimes you don't know how to get your way out. A key to focus on the positives is gratitude. Gratitude can really help because when you really reflect on all the things that you already have in your hands, all of the accomplishments and achievements that you have made, you focus on your health, you focus on your relationships, positive relationships with friends and family, then you realize that you have so much and it helps you focus more on the positives than the negatives. Tip number two to creating a fresh start after disappointment is learn from the beetle. Learn from the beetle, or another name is the scarab. And what is so amazing about that particular insect is this adaptability. Depending on the conditions and what is available to the beetle, it will find a way to feed and nourish itself so that it can still create and leave a legacy. There are some beetles that even nourish themselves on other animals' feces. There are some, if the conditions are positive, where they have access to a lot of vegetation, then they're herbivores. If they have access to both plants and other insects or animals, then they're omnivores, so they'll eat both. So they will find a way to feed and nourish themselves and create depending on the conditions that surround them. So even the smelliest, dirtiest, bacteria-ridden substance such as feces, it can still find a way to grow and thrive. Another thing about the bee, though, for tip number three is transform and go through a metamorphosis. Okay? Sometimes it can be difficult. With the beetle, it goes through abrupt structural changes in its body to go through a complete life cycle, a complete metamorphosis. One of the 12 laws is what you resist persist. And a lot of times when changes occur that are uncomfortable, we want to resist the change when actually it is the push we need to move on to the next stage of our development. Tip number four for overcoming disappointment is, I heard this from Oprah and I absolutely loved it. She said that when one door closes, it is God's, the divine creator's message to you to seek another way. It is steering you in another direction. So be open, listen, and be obedient. Sometimes what happens is that we have a plan for our life. And I love this quote. We make plans and God laughs. Sometimes we have a plan for our life, and when it doesn't pan out and things aren't going the way we want them to, we just fall all to pieces, not realizing the greatest blessing is just on the other side of that. Sometimes our visions and our dreams are too small, and God has an even larger dream for us. So sometimes that disappointment, that closed door, is sometimes the door to a shack when the bigger dream is the door to a compound. So the last and final tip on how to overcome disappointment and to create your fresh start is that once you have gone through that metamorphosis, do not resist it, because what you resist persists, but create. Knowing that in every situation, any kind of condition is the breeding ground for you to create something fresh, for you to dream a bigger dream, to return to the drawing board, to renovate, to redecorate. So the last tip is get creative and create. Yes, thank you, Dr. Jarrett, for putting in the 5 tips in the chat box. I so appreciate you. So just for a quick recap, the 5 tips on how to create a fresh start after disappointment. Number 1, accentuate the positives, not the negatives. Number 2, learn from the beetle, adapt and change. Number 3, is do not resist, go through a complete metamorphosis. Number 4 is, I'm next to this gym. Number 4 is know that when one door closes, God is steering you in a different direction to a greater, bigger dream. And number 5 is create, get creative. So with that being said, remember earlier I said that the antonym of disappointment is success, achievement, happiness, and pleasure, though just to name a few. And that disappointment is a feeling that occurs when you have not fulfilled your hopes or expectations. If you are in that place and you're like, you know what? There are things that I have wanted in my life. There are things that have occurred and they were not what I planned nor what I wanted. And so I'm feeling unfulfilled. I'm feeling displeasure. I'm feeling unhappiness. Sometimes I have feelings of failure. How do I turn that around? How do I release the burden, the overwhelm, the stress of that so that I can have success, so that I can feel my happy again, so that I can have feelings of pleasure and accomplishment and achievement? Then what I want you to do is take action. If you are ready to achieve that, go to my website, www.freelife7le.com/consultation. There you can, we should have a six, let it go. Oh, now that's a good one. That's a good one, your greater way. That's true. Now this list can go on and on beyond the five, but I honor and respect people's time, and I like fives. So I just kept it at five today. But since your greater way suggested number six, let it go. But you know what, greater way? Sometimes people have difficulty letting it go. They think that letting it go requires forgetting, and they don't know how to get through that. So sometimes we have to break some things down in bite-sized pieces, step by step, in order for them to get to the place that they can forgive and really let it go. So that's why I started where I did. So go to my website, www.freelife7le.com/consultation. There you can schedule a complimentary 15-minute free consultation with me. If you need support, if you need help, if you need coaching to help you achieve a bigger dream than what it is that you have been doing. You've been playing small, but sometimes you may have feelings of fear, overwhelm, and stress. Dr. Michelle, you say, how can I get this burden, this heaviness off of my shoulders? Dr. Michelle, you may ask, how can I feel fulfilled, have those feelings of success, achievement, accomplishment, pleasure, passion back in my life, pleasure, passion back in my work? How can I do that? Go to my website and schedule your complimentary 15-minute consultation, and we can talk about it and begin the process of developing your blueprint, your roadmap to your wellness success, your fulfillment, your pleasure, your happiness, and your dreams. So once again, I am Dr. Michelle Clay. I am speaker, author, holistic physician who specializes in the release of stress so that you can achieve your wellness success. I help exhausted executives, stressed out and burnt out professionals find their happy, healthy place so that they can live a free life on purpose and with passion. So until next time, which will be Wednesday, same time, same place, join me for Wednesday's Wellness Wisdom Pearl. Thank you for joining me. Have a beautiful, positive, and healthy evening. Be well.